This is question 29 from section 1 of the 2018 ECAA paper. In this question, we're given a line, 1 plus root 3, y is equal to px plus 5. And we're told this line is perpendicular to the line y equals 2 minus root 3, x plus 8. And given this information, we're asked to find p. So we've got these two lines. And what does the fact they're perpendicular mean? Well, it means if we take the gradient of one of them, take the inverse of it, so 1 over it, and then take the negative of that, we get the other gradient. So let's work out the gradient of both the lines to begin with, and then we can implement that. So this, well, if we just divide through by 1 plus root 3, we get the standard form of a line, and we know the gradient's this, p over 1 plus root 3. So by what we mentioned earlier, we know p over 1 plus root 3 is equal to this, 1 over it, minus, because they're perpendicular. So p over 1 plus root 3 equals minus 1 over 2 minus root 3. And now the rest of this question is essentially a rearrangement with surds, which is a little bit of a pain, but not too bad as long as we're nice and neat and careful. So first step, get p on its own. So times 3 by 1 plus root 3. And I've also brought the minus under here, so this has become minus 2 plus root 3, because the minus, if I kept it in, then there was no doubt I would somehow end up forgetting it. So it's just easier to put it in here. So we've got to here, and we don't like the look of this denominator. We don't like surd square roots on denominators of fractions. So how do we get rid of it? Well, we've got minus 2 plus root 3, so if we times it by minus 2 minus root 3, then this will have no surds in the products in the denominator. And the numerator also will be times by minus 2 minus root 3, so that our p-value is unchanged by this operation. So now let's multiply these together. So expanding the top, 1 times minus 2 minus 2, and then minus root 3, minus 2 root 3, and then plus 3 times minus root 3, which comes to minus 3. Now on the bottom, minus 2 times minus 2 is 4. Then we have minus 2 root 3 and then minus 2 times minus root 3, so plus 2 root 3. So they just cancel, which is nice. And we get minus 3 as well from the root 3 times minus root 3. But then 4 minus 3, that's 1. So that's awesome. So basically, we've just got this numerator. And that's minus 5 minus 3 root 3. And that's good because that corresponds with option A in the multiple choice. And so our answer is A.